Hooks the bar pretty much on his hook kicks. He's going to drive forward, a falling punch, of course, yeah? So an easy falling punch. Saki's a bit like that. He's got his lock drive forward, just pretty much like that. Now, we're quite keen on CKEN. That means 70% there, 30% there. Yeah? Dempsey says the most effective is the base knuckle. However, he qualifies it by saying if you start punching out with that, you break it. So he suggests the next, which he calls the middle knuckle. And the idea being, and there's a bit of sense behind it, is you can hit three knuckles on that, therefore spreading the load. Yeah? So, your intent is middle knuckle. You want to tell you what that is? First, second one in. And unlike karate, where we turn, Dempsey says, leave it that way. So, the other thing he says, instead of putting your foot down hitting, he's sort of saying, hit and foot down. Now, I don't think there'd be a lot wrong with that. I think it'd work pretty good.
Yes.
We do it slightly different. We quite like foot down, boom, hit. For me, that works better, but I haven't done it a long time, so I'm going to try it Dempsey's way. He's not being good guys at it.
Why would you want to spread the load?
Partly because, well, Dempsey says the bottom knuckle would be best for hitting because of the line. He's talking about the power line, yeah? So the power line, as you can see, that's not a bad idea. If the power line comes through more nicely. Andy, get down on the floor, he comes up Mike and grab his knee. Try not to get in. And all the firm so it doesn't wobble side to side. And there you can just stood it. Now do a few punches on Dave and just use the pivot of that knee. If you start to lever from that knee, you can really start to hit. Alright, that didn't go because you don't want to damage the knee, Andy. As he punches, I want you to do that. Yeah? That makes my point, I think. Yes? And you'll all feel this, yes? Now don't go and damage your knee. What he's talking about is it just makes that sound. You really need to imagine there's a brain going through the top of your head and out your backside. And you are working on that, yes? Once your body starts to do this, in other words, once it starts to do that and that, then it loses that momentum. So even then when your jack is okay, it's doing that. What you want to avoid is that, can you say?
Just
that, or if you like, that. And I do see people doing this, they do that.
Yes.
I'm exaggerating a bit, but that's what they do, yeah? Also, they don't use this inherent twist. If I don't even punch Simon, but I use the inherent twist, it's got massive power. And if I keep my arm locked, yes, but use the narrow twist, it's got massive hitting power. So don't let your body do this, or this. Once you use that twist to extend, you can really hit. Now there's no focus in that, but there's a lot of power coming in there. If you then start to, I can't really do it because I'll be wacky. But can you see now I'm putting a little bit of focus on the end of that? So if you put a little bit of focus on your drive, that's how you start to get these combinations. So you can learn now to be at the right distance to hit, to revolve in, it's not quite a vertical manner, it's a slightly leg forward manner, yes? Boom. Don't let his knee move about, that's going to pivot on that, yes? Your belt, if anything, should be doing that. Because your hips are moving, yeah? So distance, revolve, speed, focus, or as Dempsey says, explode.
Yes.
You've got to try now.
Because
if you plant here, for me that's about ideal. I can feel that that's good. If I go here, Steve will tell you, short. I'm not giving enough distance. So I want you all to find that again, I've been doing this a long time, so I know where I stand. A lot of you guys should know. But if you don't, adjust it till it fits stable and can tell. That's a solid hit, isn't it?
That's not bad.
I'm not going to get any speed behind that because I'm on the right distance. Yes? If you want to go set on a mass, I've got whatever I am, 14 stone, yeah? And if I don't use my body, then I'm mainly using the mass of my arm and fist, yes? However, you can get this moving pretty fast without much body. But if I get more mass of my body going and then connect, that's a totally different thing, yeah? So I can then use this momentum, this little mass times velocity. And once I start to chuck a big mass at you, it can have a heck of an effect, yeah? If you have it up, you can jump on a scale. And if you're 14 stone, jump on a scale and see where you are then. All of a sudden, that goes right through the roof, yeah? You can be hitting with 36 stone, plus however many inches, yeah? So, almost you're tripling your weight, 36 stone, here comes 36 stone, and bang, that's on the end of it, yeah? So now, I'd like you to try. We've been doing stuff where you didn't move at all, you just did this. What I'd like you to try now is we'll do Gakazuki. Chuck our weight and fire a punch at the end of it. Chuck your weight and fire a punch. A little bit of focus. So that's where practice focus. He's not hit a guy because it will destroy him. He's just aiming at something that is a position where his body would be in. Yeah? So let's now try just a straightforward focus punch. Dempsey talks about really this is a shoulder twist, but I would add hips to this. He just talks about using his shoulders. But I think use your hips. And try and focus onto the surface. This is not, you see, if I go follow through punch, Fred moves.
Yes.
But he'll probably tell you, the ones I start to hit these on the surface, these are worse than these, aren't they?
Yes,
except the second one looks more impressive because I shifted a big gap. But the ones that don't look impressive are actually very painful. Yes. So that's where. Hope you enjoyed our video. There's more information on our website, www.goju.co.uk.